Today, I will show you how to make a full sublimation jersey, from editing to final product. In this video, I will be showing the step-by-step procedure in making the full sublimation jersey, and I will be using Adobe Photoshop for editing Epson shirt color SCF6330 with sublimation ink and paper for sublimation printing, and KUI 35x23 heat press for transferring the print into the cloth. So, without further ado, let's get started. So, in making a full sublimation jersey, you need to have knowledge, or at least you know how to edit in Adobe Photoshop, Illustrator, CorelDRAW, or other editing software. But today, I will be using Photoshop since I am comfortable editing with this software. So first, open your Photoshop and open a new file. Then, adjust the width based on the size of your sublimation paper. For me, I use 43 inches width, and for the height, I will just set this to 30 since my jersey layout is just 28 inches long. And then set the pixels to 300. After that, open the grid or click Ctrl plus apostrophe on the keyboard. Then, next, make a foam part of your jersey by measuring each part of the jersey and make a half of the pattern using the print tool. Next, duplicate the pattern and flip it horizontally and merge the layers of the two half parts of the pattern, and then duplicate again to make a back part and adjust the color. So assuming that this is our pattern, and it is now ready to put some designs and other stuff, our backgrounds, type of text, numbers, and logos. Don't forget to use clipping mask when your desired design is overlapped from the pattern. So, assuming that you have a design, okay, I think this is good for me. Next, save first the PSD file your chosen location, and then save your design in a PNG format in the same location. Now it's ready to print.
In printing the jersey, I use a big machine like the Epson shirt color SCF6330 with sublimation ink and paper. So why sublimation paper and sublimation ink and not the other type of inks? It is simply because the ink is transferable, or it can be transferred to a cloth by heating using a heat press, and obviously the sublimation paper is made to be printed by sublimation ink. Then first, turn on the machine and wait until it's ready. Add your design pattern to the machine software. translate it to the software paper and then click print and wait until the printing will finish. And then cut the paper. And after that, let's turn on the heat press. I am using the 23x36 heat press by Kuyi. Let's set the temperature to 200 degrees Celsius and time to 1 minute or 60 seconds. And wait the temperature to reach to 200. So while we are waiting, we proceed to cutting of the printed paper. Let's cut the layout separately for easy cutting of clothes. Leave at least a small space from each corner of the jersey. Next, let's get a plain white cloth. Now, I am using a tri-fit cloth since it is stretchable and it is perfect for sportswear. Let's place it under the jersey and cut the cloth exceeded from the jersey by using a scissor. So, it is already 200 degrees Celsius. And now, we can transfer this ink from the paper to this cloth by hitting this on the head press. Place the cloth first and then put the paper above and press it tightly so that the ink will transfer very well. And then print the other parts of the jersey. And we can see that the ink is transferred very well in the cloth. And now it's ready to cut. And after transferring the pattern to the cloth, let's start cutting the edges of the jersey as it is an important part of making the jersey. I use a roller blade or a roller cutter for this, but if you don't have, any cloth cutting tool will do. And now, we are in the last part of making our full sublimation jersey, the sewing. This process is to connect our full sublimation pattern we made. We only made the upper jersey. We can also make a lower part of the jersey, but it has a different pattern. Maybe in the next video. Based on my experience, building this business is so expensive, like from the computer, the machine, the other materials, and it also takes a lot of time of practicing, like editing, designing, measuring materials like your jersey, especially the sewing, because it's not easy to make a full sublimation jersey. But if you really like to build a business like this, and why not? So that's it for this tutorial. I'm Gardas Vergara, and see you in the next video.